Thanks a lot for staying with us. You're rolling coverage on Budget 2019 in just about under an hour from now. Piyush Goyal, the interim finance minister, is going to be presenting the budget speech. And as we talk about several issues, the sectors, the demands that are coming to the fore, let's also go across to Niranjan Hiranandani, who's the MD and co-founder of Hiranandani Construction Private Limited. Mr. Hiranandani, what is your key hope from the budget? Can there be something to boost the real estate sector and other related sectors?
I don't think they have a choice. They're bound to do it. Real estate is not my subject. It is the Prime Minister's subject. He says housing for all by 2022. Mm. So we want housing for all by 2022. And so there is no choice. You have to do real estate as a big bang. Number two, remember, the second largest employer in the country is real estate and infrastructure. Mm. So any emphasis on infrastructure will solve your housing, your unemployment problem. So I think on both respects, we have a great expectation from the finance minister, the prime minister and the cabinet to give us a budget which has a focus on housing. Roti, kapda, makan. You have done roti, you have done kapda, but where is the makan? So we have to make this happen. I'm so glad that the elan of the Prime Minister of Housing for All will really fructify by 2022. Yes. You need to do it. There's only one point I need to add, that there is not sufficient talk about rental housing. If you take the richest country in America, in the world, America, 50% of the people live in rental housing, but all our budgets, all our policies, both at the state and central level, do not encourage sufficient investments into rental housing. I think this is an angle which probably the budget will take this time. Of course, there are various things like GST and other things which also need some attention to do it. But the biggest bang of all is liquidity
crisis. No, but Mr. Hiranandani, as far as relief to the real estate sector is concerned, what are you really looking at? Bringing GST. Under construction projects, I mean, some GST devaluation, stamp duties to be reduced. I mean, for the common consumer, these are the issues that make it slightly more tougher for them to buy a new property.
True, you're absolutely right. Nobody is going to pay 12% under construction property when your property is going to get ready in 6 months and you have to pay zero GST when it has already got occupation certificate. That's why you see so many ads with zero GST and OC, because people don't buy under construction. So I think that needs a rectification so that it becomes rational. The question was whether it will be 5 or 8 with input tax credit. I think in the next council of ministers, group of ministers report should come to the GST council, and in the next meeting we are hopeful that will happen. But this needs to be supported with adequate things in the budget also. We need to do something more for Makan. I think it will happen.
Well, absolutely. Well, Niranjan, good morning. This is Arnab here. It's it's good to see you as always on a
good
budget
morning.
Good morning, Niranjan.
Yeah.
The one question I always ask everyone on a pre-election: are you nervous? It appears to me, Niranjan, this time, as I show pictures of Piyush Goyal, I think Delhi is more nervous than Mumbai. Mumbai seems taxed this morning. They have played down and pared down their own expectations in a pre-election budget.
Well, look, elections keep on coming and going every 4 or 5 years. We are seeing all this happen all the time. I think the Prime Minister will create a momentum budget which will be second to none in the world, for the simple reason that you need to give a big bang to the country. I think he will make a new paradigm. 7.5% growth is there. Why not increase it? I'm sure he will bring in some measures which will shake this country and bring it, just like 1991 was a paradigm in terms of liberalization. I'm sure this is a big bang budget. Both Piyush Goyal and the Prime Minister will do something which is going to be great. I have great expectations.
Absolutely. Niranjan, well, thanks very much. And have a good budget day. Let's talk post-budget. Thanks very much, Niranjan. Good to see you once again. And I welcome our guests here in the studio. And as I do that,
see you too,
I have been asked on numerous occasions. Tanveer, good morning. You have your hand up there already. Yes, go ahead, Tanveer. Go ahead.
He said bye bye also. I'm hoping to do you after, of course. You have to talk also.
Tanveer? Okay, that's just a bad. Okay, that's just a bad audio signal. Akash Jindal is with me here in the studio. Akash, your overall expectation?
My expectation is that this is going to be a laddu peda budget, but perhaps the government doesn't have that much laddu pedas which people are seeking. But there are things now the government has grown very positively. We have seen demonetization. In fact, Anu, you'll remember I had lots of debates. People were criticizing. I was saying economy would be growing. Now we have the data with us. 8.2% growth we have shown during the demonetization era. So I think it would be a laddu peda budget. Yes, the seekers of laddu peda would be much higher than the government has, seeing the current fiscal deficit. But perhaps what the government is going to do is they are going to reduce the size of that laddu pedas so that laddu pedas can be distributed
I think their focus will be on winning the elections. They are not going to be affected by anything else.
Budget.
They will not be affected by their collections from GST. Yes, otherwise, you can't give laddu, you can't give peda, you can't give barfi, you can't even give chuda. If you were to look at the GST declining for a second month in a row to 94,700 crores in December 2018, this is a continued shortfall.
Yes.
If you look at it, this poses a real challenge to meet the fiscal deficit target, but that's not the way it works in a pre-election year. Pre-election year, go win, then manage the fiscal expectations next year. I have with me Sunil Khanna, Chairman CII West Region. Let me get Sunil Khanna. And Sunil Khanna, all kinds of descriptions. This is going to be a laddu peda budget. What does CII expect?
Well, CII is expecting that this budget should set the growth targets for industrial and infrastructure growth, because it is the industrial and infrastructure growth that can help in generating employment. Manufacturing sector contributes only 16-17% of the GDP. And we have to come out with schemes that can help in taking it to 20% of the GDP. Well, it is said that one job in manufacturing generates three jobs in service sector. So if we are really to focus on employment generation, we have to focus on industrial and infrastructure growth.
Okay, let's get a quick word in. Thanks very much, Sunil. Let's go to across. Let's get maximum responses from the Indian Merchant Chamber, their Vice President, Ashish Ved. Ashish, what is the broad picture? What are your expectations before I go to the political debate?
Yeah, so basically what we feel is that the emphasis will be on agriculture and on the middle income bracket. So the middle income bracket for up to 5 lakhs, the tax rates have gone down from 10% to 5% as of now. But we hope something more can be done for them because they are the real spenders in the economy. As far as agriculture is concerned, it's been suffering a lot. And there are 3-4 things which can be done. There can be interest-free bank loans. There could be MSP prices fixed. Infrastructure could be improved. Corporates could be encouraged to participate in agro industry. And that could give a big boost. Also, real estate is the second highest employer, and it's been suffering terribly. So the main reason is because the transaction costs are about 19%. There's 12% GST, there's a 5-6% stamp duty, there's a registration fee 1%. So with 19% GST, with the employment rates going down all over, if the real estate sector gets a boost, then employment will also go up. And from 40 million jobs, we are expecting 52 million jobs by 2022 if the real estate sector gets a boost.
Okay, thanks very much. I now want to go back to the political debate for a bit, Shivani out here. And let's welcome into the debate. Tanveer Ahmed has his hand up there, Dinakar Lanka, Ratan Sharda, and those are pictures at the right moment as we go to political debate. Those are pictures of Prime Minister Narendra Modi walking in on the first floor of Parliament. He's going to spend some time in his office. It's 10:16, and then he's expected to be there in Parliament in 45 minutes. These are pictures earlier that we showed you of Piyush Goyal going in. Sumant, welcome. Nupur, welcome. Thanks very much. Ravi Srivastava for staying in. And I'd like to open by giving another shot to Tanveer, if I can hear him, please. And he can hear me. Tanveer, you can hear me now? Are you feeling very nervous?
I can hear you, sir. Good morning.
An election that is good for the people of India. An election, a budget that is good for the, middle classes of India. A budget that is good for the tax-paying classes of India.
Arnab, I'm feeling...
A budget that is good for the farmers of India.
Arnab, I'm feeling great. I'm feeling good.
Worried?
Because petrified? My very good friend, Mr. Piyush Goyal, is presenting the budget, Arnab. Arnab, I'm feeling good because my friend Piyush Goyal is presenting the budget, 12th interim budget. But why are we celebrating too much? This is not a full budget. This is just an interim budget. And interim budget has certain limitations,
this
though constitution
problem,
allows
you know, you
them to make give
soap semantics.
And give laddu pedas.
You have a fundamental problem.
No, Arnab, let us
your
really
problem
ask
is
certain
that
some
you
important
don't rise
questions.
Above semantics.
When the inflation have taken the beating.
Rise above your selfish, narrow political considerations.
No, 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 no,
your chief minister is
questions.
Crying every day.
Job creations have really failed. And now you are going to come and give some laddu pedas because election is just round the corner.
What do you want him to give? Karela juice?
Laddu peda budget is what is this budget is expected. Worst agrarian crisis. Job is at the lowest of low. What can my very good friend Piyush Goyal do? He can really do nothing other than announcing some populist measures.
Lalita, I think this has to be countered now, Lalita. Go on.
Anyway,
yeah, we're over cynical.
Let me come in.
No. Let us counter it by one by one.
5 years, it depends on whose
perspective.
Feel free. You're looking
feel free.
At it.
Dr. Ajay Dua, who's former Commerce Secretary, Government of India, welcome. Good morning. Here in the studios, I've placed you right in the middle of a political debate, sir. What do you think is going on, sir? Should these considerations matter or the benefit of the people
all
of India
these
matter?
Are very important considerations.
Yes.
Whether it's farm distress, employment,
yeah.
Rationalizing,
yeah.
Whole package of, you know, banking stress sector, etc. But a budget, even if it's a full-fledged budget, can do only a limited amount of corrective
so
work.
Let's try to do it.
And this one, more so...
So this technicality that yeah. she's raising
yeah,
since morning, that you cannot, you know, you cannot present a budget.
No, no, no.
There's
you
some technical reason.
No.
You can't make, you can't
Arnab,
take decisions that are good for the people of India.
No.
Arjun, you know, you've been a career bureaucrat, sir. Please tell us. What is
no,
it?
No, I think there's no legal barrier to giving a full-fledged budget.
So please.
But...
No, what moral
let's
barrier?
Let's say. The question is...
Arnab...
Sir, that is all right.
And
but
how
the,
are you going to decide
the question
the
is,
whole year?
There are in the past.
That is why you have the.
Sir, let Ajay Dua speak, sir. He's okay. A wise man.
Okay.
Not that you are not.
Is, yeah. There's yeah. A, there have been 13 to 14 interim budgets of this kind.
Yes. Yes.
Certainly, you do not make policy decisions which are not able to and provide for it in numbers,
yes.
Provided you, if you are not able to carry them through. So, an interim budget usually does have a speech which gives the direction of government and what it would like to achieve.
That is the
it
point.
It will have a full year, but the what it
absolutely.
And at the same time, the numbers which are there, those are somewhat conservative,
so
and those are keeping more in trend with what was happening.
You know, I tell you, every time
for bigger.
Mr. Dua, in the room in
Arnab,
this case is the fact that who made populism the cornerstone of budgets? It was the Congress.
Yes.
The same party now which has lied to the nation about budget papers being leaked.
I don't understand this. What about just because the Congress did something wrong, should the BJP repeat the mistakes? What is this? What is the what about you? No, sorry. Why, if the Congress did something wrong, should the BJP be repeating those mistakes?
It's not wrong, Aarti.
So then why did you criticize the Congress all those years when they did it? You shouldn't have. No, you shouldn't have. You should have praised the Congress. You should have praised the Congress and accepted that they would also be
Lalita,
on the eve of elections.
Lalita and Arnab, coming to you.
Arnab, let's speak.
Yeah, Lalita is making a point to Aarti.
Let's speak. Let's speak.
Logic.
Let's speak for a segment which is the bottom of the pyramid. These are senior citizens of this country. who constitute almost 10% of the population, around 13 crore people. In last 3 years, the reduced interest rates have broken the back of these people and they have nothing to survive upon. Now this government should think about that they can give some kind of a relief. Only some partial relief was given by giving a fixed return of some 8% or so, but that's not going to suffice. Since 1995, government had been collecting an ample of money towards EPF, employee family pension, and that money constitutes almost for individuals 20 lakh rupees per individual. People are protesting on Jantar Mantar in Delhi, in India Gate in Delhi, and the government should hear them, that they should be given, because they are helpless. The social fabric has broken. The children don't support them. And they are totally defenseless in the country. And
that
this is the way the
you.
Government should come out and provide
Mr. Srivastav,
or some way of other.
First, kindly tell cynics like Tanveer Ahmed and Aarti Jairath that in order to help people, you need to stop, you know, giving technical reasons to stop the government from acting. I have never seen a situation where you have an entire opposition which says the government must do everything possible to not help the people. The government must do everything possible to not help the middle class.
Arnab, I only want you to answer.
I want you to wish me good morning. You'll say no, good morning.
I'm not starting that.
I want you to wish me good luck for Republic Bharat tomorrow.
Arnab,
I want you to wish me good luck for launching Republic Bharat tomorrow. You'll say no.
Good luck.
Please don't say no to everything. This no philosophy and the no way of life has to stop.
Answer one question.
Please join me on my Hindi debate.
Answer one question, Arnab. Is there going to be?
I'm not answering questions.
That is going to be the budget for the year. So, no. Why aren't you?
Okay, answer. One minute. Enough. I will have to answer this question now.
So why are we getting so excited? Why are we hyping? whatever is actually going
I've
to
got
be
got into the no habit myself. Can I?
Same government continues in office.
Mr. No. 1 minute. Mr. Sumantraman, you please listen to me, Mr. No.
I need to deny the spin that's put out. I need to deny that. That's why I've got to call it out. That's why
Mr. No, Sumantraman, I will give you a two-point answer. No, Nupur, I have to respond to him. Nupur, I have to respond to him. Otherwise, he will think it went unrebutted.
Yes. Will there be a budget?
Just say no and I'll move on.
Yes, or whatever you want to use. No, you can use that. Will there be a budget in June or not?
Can I please come in? I want to connect what Mr. Ravi Srivastav said. Mr. Srivastav, you should know only last year the Prime Minister doubled the investment in Pradhan Mantri Vay Vandan Yojana.
Ravi.
Which means that those old people who were getting pension, their pension increased to up to rupees 10,000 a month. Please do your studies and come back. And Tanveer, I'm sorry. Only yesterday the Niti Aayog clarified that the NSSO data is not complete yet. So it's a leaked paper.
I will give a clear answer.
Because till December 2018.
Ravi.
No.
Again, you are the no brigade. Every sentence of yours starts with no.
Allow me to complete.
Please, Ravi.
Excuse me. Nupur, who will complete it? Who is going to complete it?
The members who resigned. The government cannot try to cover up. You don't have jobs in the nation and you have not done your work for 5 years. Don't make stories. Nupur, stop making stories. 5 years you have not created the jobs. The highest
prices of over 7.
Ravi Srivastav and Nupur. I want to hear them.
I can't hear them.
I can't hear them.
It is not sufficient.
I can't hear them.
mechanism
I have already mentioned it. I have already mentioned it. That 8% is not going to suffice. The misery is much more. The government is sitting on a large pile of cash recovered from these senior citizens, these retired officials. They are sitting on a large pile of money. They have to return them back. How much do you spend at 2,000 rupees pension? The family pension of 2,000 rupees. Can anybody survive in that?
Just one.
Do you think
the reduction in prices of medicines?
They have got medicine. They need medicine. They need food. They need shelter. They need support. Who is providing them?
What is wrong with you?
If you will not take care of your senior citizens, the country will ultimately be doomed. You take my words.
A question has been asked.
From Ayushman Bharat Yojana.
Ayushman Bharat.
No, a question has been asked.
People, madam.
Ayushman Bharat is meant for the below poverty line people. The senior citizens are not going to be benefited by that.
And
who is getting Ayushman Bharat? Can you tell me? Can you give me a statistic? How many people have been benefited? Most of the hospitals have backed out from that Ayushman Bharat. Are you aware?
10 lakh people have already
been treated. You give the numbers. Give the numbers. So how many people have been benefited by Ayushman Bharat?
You did not listen to the president's
address. Don't put the schemes on paper. It will not help you.
Did you not
come out with the data. Show that how many people have been benefited.
10 lakh people.
Please don't talk in the air.
What are
launching
you
a scheme
to?
Does not mean that the people will be helped and benefited.
No, I'm sorry. Are you questioning the president of India?
I'm questioning
these
your statement.
The statistics given by the
I'm
president
questioning
of
your very statement,
are you questioning
madam.
Him? You have to know.
Your data are
they have been treated by Ayushman Bharat.
Okay,
what are you talking about?
And your poor
life. First time in the 45 years that there is so much of joblessness.
Nupur is concerned.
Data was
that
leaked yesterday.
I'm sorry.
Last 40
what data was leaked? What data was leaked? What data was leaked?
You are fudging.
What data leaked?
No.
Data was
yes.
What data was leaked? No, what data was leaked? Where was the budget leaked? Vivek, on what basis are you saying there was the data leaked?
It is absolutely
this is a very serious statement. What data was leaked?
In Noida, just take a round of all the management colleges, take a round of all the engineering colleges, and 90% of the kids don't get a job in the placement. So forget about it.
7.2%,
7.2%. 5 years the government has failed on all fronts.
Government has not failed.
You have failed.
Who just said this?
You are
come back to power, so you come up with all sorts of lies.
Okay, one minute. I want to come on a point on the interim budget issue. First of all, Vivek, I want to tell you one thing. Vivek, can I have some calm here? Lalita, calm down. Will you stop provoking her? Wait a minute. Will you stop? Stop her ranting. All sorts she's ranting. Then all of you are ranting. Don't make personal comments.
You don't talk.
Don't call someone ranting.
Okay.
What do you mean by calling saying she's ranting?
I mean she's not giving any logical
data.
Yeah,
but then why can you say she's ranting? She's ranting.
Okay.
Don't call it a rant.
I'm giving you lots of data. EPS
of
73.5 lakhs created in 15 months. How will you come to that? Rubbish. 73.5 lakh jobs by EPFO.
Counter the joblessness.
Have you gone through
counter
EPFO
the
data?
Crime?
Have you gone through
making
EPFO
India
data?
Answer for women?
Have you?
What do you want
what
me to counter? And what have you got to show? You have nothing to show. This budget is going to be
how
just populist only for your 2019 elections.
Now you are ranting. You are a motor mouth.
बड़ा बड़ा
you are an absolute motor mouth.
Size बड़ा रखिएगा.
Interim.
Because you anyway have to go. 2019.
You are going to be a master.
One second. One second, please, you irresponsible young man. Please stop here, Vivek. Now listen, I'll tell you one thing. Vivek, listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. A question was asked and a question will have to be answered.
You shut up.
Oh, please, 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 Vivek. This shut up, you shut up, this high-level intellectual debate. I cannot take part in
this country. All you do is have a rouse.
Let's not say shut up to each other. आपकी गवर्नमेंट ने खराब काम किया तो अब आप शट अप कह रहे हो मेरे को।
The biggest moron this country has seen.
Your government didn't work for you.
Shut up. The past 2 years.
Serious,
serious. And that also leaning left.
Serious, man. Please, please, please. Thank you, thank you. Mr. Dua. Mr. Dua. Mr. Dua.
अपनी सरकार का ध्यान रखिए।
Vivek, 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 Vivek. Please
stop. Stop talking loud. You are going. You are failing. Three states you lost. Or 2019.
Vivek, 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 when I've said it here now, I want to...
Come on, forget it.
Or rubbish.
Exactly. Ajay, I need to tell you all that it's a budget day. Okay, yeah. Please be serious.
Yes, but
my, no, Vivek, no, Vivek, no. Please stop. Vivek, please stop. Vivek, I am not having a slanging match now. Vivek, I am not having a slanging match now. Vivek, I am not having a slanging match. So Nupur and Vivek, you both have to be stopped. Ajay Dua. Ajay Dua. If people were to Tanvir. I want to have a debate between Tanvir right now, Ghanshyam and others also. Yeah. My question is, if the Congress and the UPA was all...
I have three expectations from this budget, Arnab.
While the budget estimates...
Arnab,
yes. While the budget estimates in 2013-14...
Even if it is a populist budget, I have three requests.
Yeah. Please, let him ask.
Sir, I am making a point. Can I make a point?
Let them increase the healthcare budget by 10,000 crores.
Yes.
Sir, the budget estimates in 2013-14 pre-election year,
right?
Pre-election year was 231,084 crores,
right?
In terms of subsidies,
right?
Chidambaram went ahead and took these estimates to a whopping 255,708 crores.
That's right.
So you added about 200,000 crores.
Yes.
That, in my view, is indicative of hyper-populism. Absolutely. So I do not understand how hyper-populism becomes an issue for the opposition now.
Arnab, you are absolutely on the dot. Every budget...
Arnab, here hyper-populism becomes
let them speak.
Because when you have failed in every sector, agrarian crisis is there,
have been used by the government
getting created, and inflation is at the highest of high, real estate is taking beating.
No government in history of India for the last 70 odd years has not put out a populist budget in the year prior to the general elections.
Yes.
State governments do that repeatedly in their assemblies and exactly the same thing. If the fact that this budget is likely to be populist, I think no one is treading a new path.
I want to make a small point to my friend Tanvir and Ghanshyam. Good morning to you and Dinakar, Lanka and MR Venkatesh. I will debate with all of you. I will debate with all of you till kingdom come.
And stop taxing.
I will debate with you till kingdom come, with four of you, five of you. All I'm telling you is, please give credit where it is due. Please be realistic. When the UPA Congress government doled out ad hoc subsidies, the Narendra Modi government has prudently rationalized subsidies. It has streamlined subsidies. The Narendra Modi government launched the unique Give It Up campaign, urging economically able citizens to give up the subsidy. And this ensured that LPG coverage rose from 55% in 2014 to 90% now. The principle with which Narendra Modi has run the government has been of rationalizing subsidies. He brought in direct tax transfers. The benefits of DBT reached 1.1 lakh crores till December 31st, 2018, weeding out a huge number of fake beneficiaries. My simple point as I go into the break is this. Before you accuse the Narendra Modi government of populism, please understand there is no government in the history of independent India, not one, which has rationalized and streamlined subsidies. in the clear and efficient manner that the Modi government has. If a little bit of a populist move before an election is making people like Aarti very nervous, they should do some serious introspection. I'll come back on the other side of the break, and viewers, Republic Bharat is launching tomorrow. Let's get a view from Corporate India. Rajan Vadera, who is joining us from the CII, is president at Mahindra and Mahindra. Mr. Vadera, good morning. Can you hear me? Your expectations from your sector, industry overall.
Good morning, Arnav. Our expectation is on the CKD side, we do not want any custom duty increase. Also, on the commercial vehicle, CBU, we would want the duties to go up from the current duty to help the Make in India cause. Also, we have to make huge investments consequent to a lot of regulations that are coming. So we want direct taxi rate to come down to 25%. And we also want that there is the weighted deduction that is at 150% to go up to 200%. So these are some of the things that we are looking forward to.
Okay. We are 14 minutes from budget presentation, so I'll have to say thanks, Mr. Vadera. Thank you very much. I think from Fiki also.
Thank you.
From Fiki, Mr. Sandeep Somani, are you there? Mr. Sandeep Somani, president of Fiki, is with us right now. Mr. Somani, big pre-election budget. Fiki has put up a wish list. How realistic is it?
Well, I think we are looking at this not as purely as a vote on account. We are looking at it like an interim budget, which should give directionality and should spell out the strategy to take us out of some of the issues that industry is facing. And I think to that extent, our wish list is quite realistic.
Right. Mr. Somani, stay with us. Pawan Goenka of Mahindra and Mahindra also with us. Mr. Goenka, everybody, you know, I find it interesting that industry is welcoming the fact that this is like a full budget. Industry is actually welcoming it all over.
Well,
what do you mean, Dare? Yeah, don't make these kind of sweeping comments. Mr. Goenka is going to speak. No, please.
When it's in power.
Please.
Go on, sir.
May I? Hello?
Yeah, go on.
Hello?
Yes, go on, Pawan.
Yeah. So, not a full budget, but interim budget, and therefore some things may happen. However, my view is that most of what industry is saying, which are big ticket items, perhaps will not happen in this budget. The biggest thing that we are looking for is reduction in corporate tax, which was promised that it will happen in 4 years. 4 years is this budget, but I don't expect that to happen because in the current fiscal situation, it's unlikely that the government of India will give a big relief to large corporates. So I don't expect it. Many of the things that we have talked about in terms of direct taxes in personal income tax perhaps will not happen. Maybe something very nominal, very sort of directional might happen, but nothing big. I think the whole budget is going to focus on farmers, on rural economy, and the minimum guaranteed income, that is UBI scheme, in some way or shape or form should come in this. But that will be the main thing that I expect from this budget.
Pawan, thanks very much. Pawan and Mr. Somani, thanks very much. Chandrajit Banerjee of CII is going to be joining us in a minute. And before that, I want to go back to the political debate here. M.R. Venkatesh, why is this unnecessary debate happening, which people like Dinakar Lanka and Tanveer Ahmed and Ghansham and everyone else out here is starting about why the government is trying to present something more than an interim budget?
Arnab, there is nothing called an interim finance minister. There is nothing called an interim budget. The government of the day is well entitled under the constitution to present a budget. That's all. Period. Full stop. Now, if Mr. Lanka or anybody else wants to find fault
what
with
full
it,
stop? You are there. Let him wait. Let Tanveer please respond to that. Yeah. I've named people.
Let me complete. Tanveer, I know it's a Barnaul moment, but please hold on for it. please, please hold on. Now listen, every time every government has presented something before the polls, and it is called politically savvy. It is, you can be politically savvy. You can label, you can label it politic. What word?
Are,
what did I use?
You never hear what I have spoken about the budget. You are using my name means what it is. It, you are preoccupied mind in which you are delivering your debate. It is not good.
I am saying Arnab use the Arnab. You Dinakar, you use the word. Now let me
let
focus on the budget. I don't want
Mr.
to get
Venkatesh,
I don't,
let you explain
I don't,
that.
I don't want to get distracted.
What about the current account deficit? Whether it is crossing 2% or not? What about the fiscal deficit? It is expected 6.5 lakh crore, whereas by third quarter itself 7.5 crores it reached. Isn't it fact?
It is only expected. No, it's your calculation.
FDI.
Mr. Dinkar Rangani, it's your calculation, not the government's calculation.
Let you discuss about the net FDI.
And current account deficit,
came out from
current
the
account deficit is on
this
account
is
of higher fuel bill.
We debate.
Nothing else.
Let you debate. What about the promises and assurances given to the state of Andhra Pradesh?
This is not the professional way, Mr. Rangani, you debate. When I'm speaking, you jump in.
People of this
it is like Hanuman in Lanka, not Dinkar Lanka.
The effect of the 5 crores Andhra Pradesh people.
Hanuman in Lanka, this man is Hanuman in Lanka, not
Dinkar Lanka. How much funds are you giving for Polavaram? How much funds are you giving for Schedule 13?
Okay, Tanvi. Gancham and MR. First MR, then Gancham. Go on, MR.
Nothing you have. Nothing you have.
Arnab, Mr. Dinkar Lanka is talking. Dinkar Lanka must distinguish between a budget for Andhra Pradesh and budget for the country. We are not talking about Cholavaram's budget. We are talking about budget for the country. And this government has done phenomenally very well by reducing the mother of all taxes, namely inflation. So he Dinkar must understand.
I just want
this
to say that for
that the government
Piyush Goyal,
the biggest
a young
tax,
minister in the government, it is his first budget. I want to congratulate him in his movement.
Inflation has been at a historic low.
I just wanted to congratulate Piyush Goyal as a finance minister. He's presenting his first budget as a young minister. It's a big moment for him. I want to congratulate him for that. At the same time, I also want to clearly demark this conflict of interest. He is a national treasurer of Bharatiya Janata Party, and as a national treasurer of Bharatiya Janata Party, or the last formal national treasurer of Bharatiya Janata Party, if I want to use politically correct language, there is a clear conflict
of
interest.
What is that? What is that got to do with
this? Budget is at best a manifesto of Bharatiya Janata Party going into 2019.
This is verbal
diarrhea. It will have no bearing. It is not
by your own standards.
Any bearing in. It will have no bearing into what the next government will do.
Ganshyam ji, have some sense and talk now. What has Piyush ji's treasurership got to do with this? Why are you trying to make? You mean to say a treasurer of party can never become the finance minister? What are you talking, sir?
Simultaneously cannot be, sir. You have access to. You have Bharatiya Janata Party gets 80% donations from of
sir,
all political parties from unknown
it?
Sources.
What?
You have access to all
what
these.
Is
there is something like Diwan Housing Financial
yes.
Corporation. The news that is coming out. Apparently DHFL gave 20
issue.
Crore to Bharatiya Janata Party. Apparently this is the largest scam
some,
in the
some,
making.
Some,
apparently
some
this must be in the knowledge of the current finance minister. For you to say that there is no conflict of interest. Is pulling yourself and pulling the viewers.
Truth be told, Vivek. And Chandrajit Banerjee is with me right now. Let's go.
आपके पास डोनेशंस आते हैं आप बताते नहीं हो कहां से आ रहे हैं नूपुर स्टॉप टॉकिंग बिग
नूपुर
नूपुर यू डोंट डिस्क्लोज योर डोनेशंस सो डोंट टेल अस यू डोंट डिस्क्लोज वेयर द मनी इज कमिंग फ्रॉम
नूपुर एंड विवेक
आई मीन यू इट्स अ बिग रिच यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फाइनेंसेस ऑन नेशनल टेलीविजन
प्लीज आप लोग लाखों करोड़ रुपए लेते हो डोनेशंस में यू डोंट टेल द पीपल वेयर इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम
आई चैलेंज द एंटायर बीजेपी पैनल टू टेल अस
यू ट्राई टू बेनिफिट
फ्रॉम
द एंटायर बीजेपी पैनल विल नॉट
आपके पास है ही नहीं आप छुपाते हो सारे नाम आप उनको बेनिफिट्स देते हो अपनी गवर्नमेंट से
No, I forget it. He called
me. Batao na. Donor donors list kaha hai BJP?
Why do you call people?
Where is the list of the donors of the BJP?
Vivek, can I request you to be quiet for a minute? I'm making a substantial point. We have an eye on the markets. The markets, please, Vivek. Vivek, please. Vivek, please.
Vivek, please.
Before I go to Chandrajit Banerjee, I want to tell you a couple of things out here. 2% interest subvention on SMEs and textile industry. Nupur, I cannot speak over you, so I'm not speaking over you now. In the interim budget for 2009, then Finance Minister Chidambaram announced a 2% big interest subvention on post and pre-shipment credit for textile industry, other SMEs. That was a very populist move. Recapitalization of public sector banks. Pranab Mukherjee, while presenting the interim budget for 2009, announced the recapitalization of public sector banks over the next 2 years to help them maintain a capital to risk-weighted asset ratio of 12%. That plan to recapitalize banks was also seen to be a populist move. Agricultural subsidy is the big elephant in the room. In 2009-10, UPA announced the following figures: 44,863 crore subsidy on fertilizers. Separately, 10,960 crore subsidy on food. Separately, on top of this, 15,000 crores in an agricultural debt waiver and debt relief schemes. Huge package on agricultural subs. Dare these people to talk about populist moves right now, and you talk about other things. Chandrajit will remember, though I don't want to drag him in a political debate. IIFCL refinancing commercial bank loans. 2009, later president, then finance minister, announced that India Infrastructure Finance Company Limited will refinance 60% of commercial bank loans for projects in important sectors for the next 18 months. Was that not a populist move? So please, you know, you want to talk subsidies and populism, I can also talk. Please understand out here, the Modi government enabled the rationalized system of subsidies where they introduced geo-tagging in the MNREGA scheme, and geo-tagging allowed the monitoring of work and simultaneously ensured 100% expenditure via the electronic fund management system. So there has been transparency this time. You don't want this.
MNREGA,
you want niche se. You want niche se. The table ke niche se. Chandrajit is there. Chandrajit, your thoughts before the budget. My God, this is going to be a volatile one. Please, is your name Chandrajit?
Not to the business.
Is your name Chandrajit?
Not to the rich people.
Are you Chandrajit or Piyush
Goyal? No, whatever. Or somewhere in between.
Let him speak, for God's sake. That's the problem with the Communist Party.
Okay, okay.
Please.
One point which is very clear, yes, there has been in the past certain interim, during the interim budget, certain announcements which has been continued after the new government has come in. Is the classic example of what happened in 2015. Having said that, everything which is going to be done for the agri sector or for the common man, which might sound populist, might not be very bad for economics and for the country. So having said that, we would like to see, yes, a lot more attention being given to the farm sector in this interim budget. We would like to see the direct benefit transfer being well leveraged to see that we are able to reach. We need to see asset creation announcements even for in the agri sector. So we would like to see that huge impetus in the agri sector in the budget. We will also have to watch how the finance minister is able to maneuver and navigate through through the challenges of fiscal, which is going to be a challenge, but he has to maneuver through that. And lastly, I think also we would need to see more disposable incomes in the hand of the of people, and for which there has to be certain certain decisions taken on the tax side. So these are important things to see how we are able to create demand in the economy, which is so important. Agri sector is important for corporate India as much as it is important for India. So we need that these boosts in this budget, and it is a futile debate to say what can be done in an interim budget and what cannot be.
Well done. Well said. See, Chandrajit, that is the real problem. You know, India cannot come to a standstill because there's an election. And Ajay Dua, former Commerce Secretary, listening on, agrees with you and wants to add on something.
See, the question is
to what Chandrajit says.
Certain benefits industry may ask for, concessions the industry may ask for it in direct terms.
Yeah.
Taxes and other things, which probably there may not be enough headroom for this government to concede. But to create a greater demand for their industrial product means that there needs to be more of income, disposable income in the hands of the public. And this time, and I'm actually very happy that the industry is taking a larger view, that the demand is growing from the rural sector.
Yeah.
The rural sector, no, the focus of the budgets, though the governments, absolutely, every government may have talked about it, yeah, but it didn't translate its intentions into numbers.
Yeah.
So this budget, we look forward to seeing the farm and the that's rural sector point getting more, you know, as attention.
Dua, I said,
and in the process, there will be greater demand for industrial products.
And as far as the interim budget is concerned, now assume if the government gives some concession, supposingly the income tax threshold limit is increased to 5 lakh rupees.
Which it should,
now, which it should be. Yes. Then what it means is benefit for the people. The new government, hypothetically assuming it's a different party, they won't be able, absolutely, to withdraw it. So it would work well for people. If the government wants to do something for the people, so I think we should definitely look beyond, to make the beyond politics. The so if something they are doing for public, you should cooperate. You must cooperate. Don't you care for the public? Just tell me.
No, don't you care for the public?
I am not a politician. I am an economist. If they give some concessions to the public, then what? If they give some concessions to the public, now then you would be able to, you won't be able to take them back. Is that your problem? Is that your problem that if they give some concessions to the public, to industry, how would you take them back?
Can I say something?
No, no, that's what I want to know.
We are 1 minute away.
If they are giving,
well, okay, we are cutting live to parliament. The speaker is there.